Our next guest came up with some of the most memorable ads and one TV character who packed quite the punch. His name is Grahame Bond.
There's no mistaking this Aussie TV legend, Grahame Bond, and his 70s creation, Aunty Jack.
Colour has an unnatural effect on pirates, turns them into ladies.
And how cool was it to be the first on our screens in colour when we switched from black and white in 1975? Grahame also started his own advertising agency. Remember this jingle that lasted for more than 20 years? And there's no other store like David Jones. He still has the gloves and he still knows all the chords. So let's welcome him back to the bright lights of Studio 10. Put your hands together for Grahame Bond.
Well, it's only when I wore dresses I was royalty.
Welcome back to the show. Now, Jono was telling us he was dying to be part of the interview because he said that you gave him his start in showbiz.
This is true. I was asked to do some work at 2WS and they said, would you like to get somebody to do the show with you, a late-night show on a Sunday night? And Gary McDonald was doing Norman Gunston, yeah. And Rory had a family. Oh. And Jono
and Dano
was...
wasn't available.
No,
Dano wasn't born.
He wasn't even born.
He wasn't even born then. And I said, what? I've got a young guy called Jonathan Coleman. I said, he's terrible, but, you know.
that became the Rex and Bruce show, which lasted for 6 months.
6 months. Lasted every Sunday night, we go, hello.
Hello. Hello, Rex. Hello, Bruce.
Oh, lots of deep voices. And, and we used to do 3 hours on a Sunday night.
Yep.
And then Jono stayed at 2WS.
Oh, wow. And the rest is history.
And the rest is history, yes. Oh. Doing advertising.
But also this guy and Rory wrote lots of advertising jingles, so that could be nappies. Kimby, Kimby, Kimby.
Yeah. And I did the vocals. And they weren't going to do it. But no, the interesting one was I always push limits, you know. I mean, yeah. I was just talking to young guys before I came on, just saying, you know, I tried to work at Channel 10 and they just weren't ready for it. No, they really weren't ready for it. They really pushed the limits. They did the Grahame. I wanted to do a show called the Captain Bloody Show, and they went, no, why don't you call it the Grahame Bond Show? And I knew I'd lost at that point. And so anyway, we went through all that. But with David Jones, I started to get really bored with it, and I said, look, I think what you've got to do is you've got to appeal to the regional areas. And yeah. I said, I'll write a special David Jones, because we've done Father's Day David Jones, everything David Jones, and I did one for the regional country areas, and I went, why don't you walk right into David Jones? If you think that you've got worms, we've got the best in ointments, the best in tablets. And they went, no, I don't think we can do that.
wasn't it a love song that you wrote to a girl that
it was.
Ditched you and you thought, I'll show her. She shouldn't have ditched me. I'm going to rewrite this song.
It should have been There's No Other Girl Like Barbara Jones. That's right.
Well, it was sort of, that was the song. She left me and she went off to England.
You showed her.
Yeah, I showed her. No, and every time she came back to Australia and she heard the jingle, she'd throw up. Wow.
So, what is the secret then to a jingle that stays with us? Because
I'll talk a little bit about it, but there's a genius advertising man in the book who's based on a lot of horrible people I met in advertising. what is it? The earworm of getting that hook in there. Mm. It's not even a matter of playing it a lot of times. If you can get them in the first, say, five listens, then they're there. John that David Jones thing ran for 30 years.
But Singo used to be able to do it, and Mojo, because it was that you ought to be congratulated. Up there, Kazali and all that kind of stuff.
Hey.
But I bet, what a great book. What a good idea for Christmas. Is that you write that book?
That's a novel.
Does he do sales? Yes, it's a novel.
How do I get one? What's the price?
I can't.
Well, look, it's on the screen.
On the screen, there it is.
This has all the tales of debauchery, doesn't it, from the ad? Because advertising and show business, they seem to go together, both you and John. Is it just a common love of... common love of sex, drugs and booze, or is there something more to it?
Well, and women.
There's a lot more to it. Look, 4 years ago, I started to write this book. And in the interim, Brexit happened,
yep.
Right? And then Donald Trump came along and suddenly the whole world changed. And it was getting very difficult for comedy writers. So in writing this book, I looked at it and I thought, well, this book is so weird, they haven't caught up to it yet, but it's getting weird. So I'll just give you a little breakdown on what it's about. It's sort of... what would I say? It's a fable, yep. And all fables are narrated by animals, and mine's narrated by a dead pig. And it's set on an island paradise, and for the Greek scholars out there, it's called Malacca.
Yes.
Okay. sorry, are there any Greeks out there? Sorry. Sorry. Yes. So it's basically, it's the story of two tribes, and there's the fat tribe, the fatties, and then there's a group of small pygmies. And the pygmies happen to be headhunters, and they're very nice people, but every now and then they just need to get some protein so they get a fatty and they eat them. But they're still very nice people. Apart from that, they're lovely people.
Like the media. It's like television, radio, right. Advertising.
Well, on this island, this paradise...
So it's an autobiography, you say?
yeah, close. Eventually, there's an intervention, and the missionaries come in and they start to change the whole island and they're influenced by the West, and they become a democracy, and then they become a kleptocracy, and they start to you know, sell off the island, like all politicians with their nose in the trough, and these politicians sell it off, and they sell the forests and the woods and everything, and until it's totally devastated, and they need, this is it, an advertising agency. So they bring in Kevin Hunter. Of Kevin Hunter, Hunter, Hunter and Hunter. Now, Kevin Hunter is famous for his 80s campaign for the Tampax for Active Men. Tampax for Active Men.
Oh, Tampax.
Tampax for Active Men. Oh. So what you've got to look at is, who would ever forget his line?
I mean,
his
amazing line
is, if you're swimming with the sharks or running with the bulls, don't leave home without them.
Oh, that's nice.
That's that one.
Where can I get one?
So it's in the book.
So it's like a modern-day Animal Farm kind of thing.
It
is. With jokes.
Yes, funny. Hopefully it's funny.
The way you're writing that book, there could be a return of Auntie Jack, couldn't it?
Well, it's pretty close.
I mean, they're really ready for
it's
you now.
It's the madness. It's, yeah. You know, I mean, I looked, as I said, with Trump and with Brexit, the world's mad.
Yeah.
And this book is just verging on being a little bit madder than what's
happening. Look at Auntie Jack. We grew up with Auntie Jack when I was going to high school and primary school. Do you think a network like the ABC or a commercial network would have the guts to even do an Auntie Jack show these days? They give you 5 weeks or 4 weeks.
Could
or
you get away with gender bending? And
that's Rebecca Riggs in that last photograph. Yeah, sorry.
but dude, like a show like this, I mean, it's strange, isn't it? I feel like we're now almost more conservative than we were back then.
Well,
but it's the progressives that are conservative or something. Mm. We were talking before about banned words.
Well, I just think I think young people have got a whole different approach. I don't know about books. I might get this on
I love the way Grahame says young people.
Young people. young people.
Because you're, over 50 now, 55, 60?
74 today.
74 today?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Grahame.
Oh, happy birthday.
Oh, my God.
Red gloves. Oh, you're very
happy
kind.
Happy birthday.
Oh, thank you.
Get your in the front.
This is beautiful. Daniela Buttrose from Buttercream Lane.
It's too good to eat.
That's fantastic.
So it's concrete.
No.
Well, the black and white TV thing.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
And your old contract's inside.
What contract?
We baked Rory into it as well.
Daniela, that is amazing. I can't believe that, judging by the photo, you obviously made it before 1975.
It's a very old cake for a very old man.
So just if I wanted to get the book before Christmas, just a quick little plug, because you're so humble about your book stuff.
Have you mentioned the book?
I don't think he's even mentioned it.
I don't even mention the book. That's it. Well, they've seen it. They've put it up there.
Oh, okay.
I
mean, that's it. Grahame's happy.
Yeah, I'm happy. No, it's there. It's out in bookshops.
And, the Great Pink Hunter.
The Great Pink Hunter, yeah. So it's... it was all based on a story I heard years ago about Jeff Atherton told me, actually, and it was an Aboriginal tribe sitting in the middle of the desert with American buyers. The American buyers were sitting over their shoulder and they were saying to them, honey, we told you how to do these dot paintings. You know the colour of the palette. The colours this year in America are orange and lemon. And just go with what we're telling you, OK?
Rayon bond, everyone.